Is your Amazon online store similar to any other business that has to pay general and administrative expenses? Well, watch this video on how an Amazon online store would pay, record, and view general administrative expenses that are not related to buying and selling. And as a bonus, I will show you all the techniques and tricks to find anything in your Amazon QuickBooks file. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. How would you record non-Amazon related expenses in your QuickBooks file that manages your Amazon merchant store? Well, you would record it like any other company records paying expenses. You would use the Write Checks window even if you're making a payment to an expense through your bank account instead of handing out a physical check. The cash in the bank will decrease and the recorded expense account will increase for the amount of expense that you pay. Those expenses will show in the bottom of the profit and loss report. For example, let's imagine on May 15th, we paid Con Edison for utilities $1,000 with check number 61. Cash decreases by $1,000 and utilities expense will show up for the first time on your trial balance and profit and loss for $1,000. Before we record this check, let's take a look at the numbers in the trial balance. Notice that cash in bank is $7,155, and after this check, it will become $6,155. Also notice you do not have utilities expense listed at all, but after you record this check, utilities expense will show up for the first time as $1,000. We already put the check shortcut in the icon bar in an earlier video, so just click check, bring the date forward to May 15th, and Con Edison, that is the electric company in New York, is not yet on the vendor list, so click add new, new vendor, click OK, Con Edison, and click OK. Now you can put $1,000 and push tab. Notice the $1,000 gets copied to the bottom left. Click once under the word account to bring the pull down arrow. Click on the pull down arrow to get your chart of accounts. And the reason we're paying this check is for utilities expense. So the money is coming from Chase Bank to the utilities expense account. Now, before we click save and close, I suggest you remove this checkbox that says you're going to print the checks later and put in the check number of the physical check that you wrote and mailed out to Con Edison. Now click save and close, and the numbers in the trial balance are exactly as we predicted. Cash in Chase Bank is down to $6,155, and utilities expense has shown up for the first time as $1,000. If you look specifically at the profit and loss, you can see that your income section is on the top part and your expense section is on the bottom. Your administrative expenses get deducted from the gross profit from the sales. So we have the money that came in from the customer minus what you paid for the merchandise that went out equals your gross profit. And then after that, you would subtract out your Amazon expenses as well as your general and administrative expenses to get the net profit and final net income for the month. I did not put a date range, but if I put from May 1 to May 31st and then click refresh, you will see that the only transaction I had during the month of May was paying utilities, and I did not record any income from deposits during May, and that's why it looks so crazy. But it would not happen this way because you will be recording your bi-monthly deposits in the way that we learned in the prior video. And now that you know how to record each of the different types of transactions that you need to record, let's take a moment and discuss the best way to find transactions that you have already entered. The first way is through the trial balance. Now, the trial balance gives a total of each of the accounts in the chart of accounts. However, if you would like to see all of the transactions that added up to that total, all you have to do is double click on the money amount and another window will pop open. That window is called Transaction by Account, and it will tell you the specific account that it's looking at right here in the top left. So, if I want to know why I have this much money recorded in my bank account, I open the trial balance and double click on the number 61577. When I double click, this window opens up, giving me a list of every single transaction that adds up to that final number. Notice it has the $9,657 deposit from video number 2. It has all of the checks that we recorded for purchasing the product that lowered the bank account. And it even has this check to Con Edison for the general utilities expense. So this window explains all of the different transactions that added up to that number. It gets even better. You can even pick a transaction and double click right on it, and the very window that you actually recorded the transaction in will show up right in front of you. Once it's there, you can change anything you want and click save, and the numbers in your reports will immediately adjust themselves accordingly. Another good way to find anything in the file is to use the Find window. You can open the Find window by going to the top left and clicking Edit, Find. Now, if you're looking for a check, you would choose Check and click Find, and every check you wrote would show up here. If you reset it and you want to find a check for a specific vendor, you would click Payee, choose the vendor, and click Find. You can put in even further filtering criteria to find checks between specific dates, checks with specific check numbers, or amounts. You can click Advanced, and then you could go down to transaction type, or you can just click anywhere and push the letter T and you get transaction type, and then you could choose deposits. Click find and every line on every deposit that you have will show up here. So I invite you to explore and experiment with both the simple and the advanced tab in the find window, and if you want, you can click Edit Find, and at the moment this is in front of you, you can click View, Add Find to the icon bar, and click OK. And now you have a shortcut to the Finder. The third thing you should know when being able to manage your file and find any transaction is that the best report in QuickBooks is the journal report. Now, the journal report is the best report in QuickBooks because it's the only report that can show everything in the order in which it was entered, regardless of date. It can show date and time that you entered it, regardless of the date of the actual transaction. And it will help you see what was entered and exactly where you left off if you were putting in a bunch and lost track of which ones were entered and which ones were not. So let me show you how to open it, set it up, and save it. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Now, don't worry about this little tip. Click Don't Bother Me and click OK, and now you have the journal report. Now, by default, it opens month to date, and it looks into your Windows clock to see what date you told Windows was today's date. But I suggest you click here to get the date pull down and choose all, meaning you want QuickBooks to show you the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now we could stretch it wide, but you would still have to scroll up and down in order to see everything. Now, I suggest you further customize this report before you save it to your icon bar. You can customize any report by clicking in the top left and click Customize, and the Modify Report window opens right up. Now, here's how we're going to change it. We're going to add a column that will tell you the date that the transaction was actually entered or last modified. Now click OK and you will see that it added this column right here. So this is the date of the transaction, but this is the date and time it was actually entered. Let's click Custom Report again and change the columns at the end. This will be helpful to you if you scroll down. I think if you're not an accountant, it would be better to remove the check marks next to debit and credit and click the check mark for one number amount. Now instead of saying debit and credit, you simply have an amount column that makes things more simple. There's another way to get rid of a column. You see the ADJ for adjustment? All you have to do is move, by the way, it's check marked on the cost of goods sold adjustment so that you can see which entries are adjustments and which entries are transactions. But you can get rid of it by moving the cursor right here, the mouse pointer right to the right of the column till you get the double arrow, click and drag to the left, and that column will disappear. Now you can even make a column wider. You can make the memo column wider, the account column much wider, just by clicking and dragging. And you could change the shape of the window and make any column as wide as you need it. Once the journal looks the way you need it to look, you click View, Add Journal to the icon bar, and then click OK. Now, if you open the journal and scroll to the very bottom, you get the most recently entered transactions, and you will always know where you left off. Now, I know that this little video series was very abbreviated. It did give you everything you need in QuickBooks if you only buy and sell on Amazon. But some students want a little bit more detail and elaboration for both the setup steps as well as the transactions and the adjustments that we recorded. So here's what I suggest. You should watch on this very website Introduction to QuickBooks with Receivables, especially if you do additional business over and above buying and selling on Amazon. If you really want to know how to utilize the utilities that QuickBooks offers, you could watch the course QuickBooks Credit Cards and Banking Transactions, also called Registered Checks and Deposits. And of course, for those people who want to make sure that their records are accurate, you can take the QuickBooks Bank Reconciliation course right here on this website. And of course, the people who would like to save time, if they write a lot of checks and they don't want to record each one, you could also take the Bank Feeds course. I thank you for taking this QuickBooks Online Amazon course, and I wish you good luck with your Amazon merchant store.